guys, it's Chris. I wanted to go over a couple of things with you. Jamie's downstairs putting the kids to bed. By the way, this is Maggie. She is our, she is our Harlequin Great Dane. She's 120 pounds. She's an absolute monster, and she can stand as tall as I can. When we have a, we'll have a house sitter and people watching the house while we're gone, but she holds down the fort for most of it. So I'm going to go over a couple things with you when it comes to traveling internationally. Just a couple quick tips as far as your passports, double checking those, money, cell phone, and just a couple of small different things. So here we go, guys. So the most important thing when it comes to international travel is your passport, because you can't get in, can't get out without it. Make sure that it is stored in a safe place at all times. Don't put it in your back pocket. And before you leave the country, make sure there is two or three blank pages for you experienced travelers. Some countries want that. And always use the 6-month rule when it comes to your expiration date. That's very important. One quick tip on when it comes to minors, don't bring in birth certificates. You have to have a passport form, no matter what the age. Quick story about that. Jamie and I just got back from Belize for Christmas with the kids, and we spent an extra day in Houston before we left because of that passport issue. We did get it done, but it took all day. Some things that you have to have if you run into that situation with your kids or anybody, yourself, is you need to go to CVS or Walgreens that day, get you a passport photo there, Google a DS-11 form, DS-11 form. It's on a PDF format. You Google it and email it to somebody at Office Max. Get it printed up, fill that out, and have proof that you're leaving the country fairly quickly. You have to have proof of that. We got all that done and had our itinerary, so that was good. All right, so let's talk about money real quick. When it comes to cash, I recommend taking cash out before you leave the country, so you don't have to worry about swiping your credit card and getting charged a foreign transaction fee. That's just what we do. It's not what you have to do, but that's something just to save a little money in fees. I recommend that. Also, when you're at your local bank before you leave, notify them that you are leaving the country. Let them know when you'll be back and say, hey, I'm leaving on this date. I'm coming back this date. Just to make sure that they don't cancel your card, decline it anywhere. Just that's one thing that banks do to prevent fraud. One thing that I've not been to Europe yet. So traveling in European countries, when it comes to that, they have on their credit cards the chip, the new chips are embedded within it, so you can't see it. So they haven't quite completely caught up with our chips that we use. So if you're at a place where you need to swipe and there's no individual, there's not a person there, it's just an automated system where you swipe some kind of gas station and it's late at night, sometimes they might not read that. So that's something to definitely be aware of. Okay, so when it comes to cell phones, turn your cellular data off before you get to that country if you do not have an international data plan and an international phone plan. If you plan to be on your phone all the time and talk on your phone, get you some kind of phone plan before you leave. Me personally, my family and I don't do that. We don't want to have our, attached to our phones. We try to just detach from all the technology in the world. So we do FaceTime our immediate family, or if Jamie and I are gone without the kids, we'll FaceTime them or get on Facebook Messenger. We just make sure we connect to Wi-Fi. But cellular data, turn it off. No data, no Google Maps. So buy yourself a map when it comes to your traveling, you're walking around to navigate where you're going if you're not staying at a resort. That's one thing that we do. I actually found an app when it came to Belize. I downloaded it, and it's kind of a little, it's all right, but it helps me a lot when it comes to getting around. Okay, one quick tip. When it comes to medicine, Advil, Tylenol, any kind of headache medicine, any over-the-counter meds, if you need that, buy it before you leave, because if you need it, if you're international, it might cost you a little bit more. So something to consider there. Also, check your travel alerts before you leave the country. I meant to cover that when it comes to the passports before you leave the country, but that's something that's very important. Make sure that you're checking what's going on, know what's going on in the world. And if you know what's going on in the country you're traveling to, then you should be fine. But travel alerts, check that. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions at all, just leave the question in the comment box and we will get it answered for you. Hope you're inspired to get out there, book that flight, and make memories and travel more. Be sure to hit like and subscribe for any new upcoming videos that we'll be posting. See you guys.